வந்தே சிம்புமுமாபதிம் சுரகுரும் வந்தே ஜகத்காரணம் வந்தே பன்னகபூஷணம் சசிதரம் வந்தே பசூனாம் பதிம் வந்தே சூர்யசசாங்க வன்னிநயனம் வந்தே முகுந்த பிரியம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயஞ்ச வரதம் வந்தே பக்தஜன ஆஸ்ரயஞ்ச வரதம் வந்தே சிவம் சங்கரம். ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், இன் தி பவல்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி எர்த் வி ஹாவ் கோல்ட். வென் வி டிக் டீப் வி வில் பி இன் ஏ பொசிஷன் டு ஃபைண்ட் கோல்ட், பட் நாட் தி பர்னிஷ்டு பிரைட் ஆர்னமெண்டல் கோல்ட். தி கோல்ட் அவைலபிள் இன் தி பவல்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி எர்த் இஸ் இம்ப்யூர், இட் இஸ் கண்டாமினேட்டட், இட் இஸ் பொல்யூட்டட், இட் இஸ் மிக்ஸ்டு வித் மட், இட் இஸ் மிக்ஸ்டு வித் டர்ட். தட் கோல்ட் is to be purified, it is to be cleaned, it has to undergo a process of purification, then it becomes 24 carat gold. That impure gold becomes pure gold. To make the impure gold pure, there are several steps, and those steps are the process, and they are many. In Kolar, Karnataka, there are gold mines, and they find the steps to be 26, from the raw gold to the refined gold there are 26 steps. Similarly, in the bowels of the earth, you have oils. We have diesel, we have petrol, we have several other oils like kerosene, but they are not usable. They are crude oils. This crude oil is to be refined. It has to be modified, purified. If you go to an oil refinery, if you talk to the engineers there, they will tell you there is a process of purification, and there are 20 steps, right from the crude to the refined form, there are several steps. Similarly, children are born, man is born. When the baby is born, the baby is not refined, the baby is not civilized, the baby is not disciplined, cultured, purified. You can see any small baby playing with the urine, sitting in the urine. It sits in the excreta. It does not know the distinction between urine and good water, excreta and good food. It is unrefined. It is uncivilized. From that rude person to the refined person, we have to improve. Gold is to be modified, purified. There are 26 steps. The crude oil is to be refined, there are 20 steps. And this rude person has to become the refined person, a yogi. There are several steps. They are called in Sanskrit samskars, purificatory steps. And these steps, if we follow, we become men and women of culture. culture, when translated into Sanskrit roughly, is Samskruti. Prakruti is nature. Vikruti is nature not well utilized, improved, but brought down. Prakruti, Samskruti, Vikruti. It is up to us whether to maintain that nature as we were born or to improve it or come down. All of us have come from the subhuman level, from the dogs, from chimpanzee, from animals. We have come to this level. Now we are human. From the subhuman species, we have come to be human. It is up to us to become superhuman or divert to be inhuman. If we are inhuman, we are rakshasas, demons, devils. If we are superhuman, we are divine, yogis. If we are subhuman, animals. From the animals, we have come to this level. The option is given to man. We can revert to be subhuman. We can promote ourselves to be superhuman. We can divert ourselves to be inhuman. And we can remain human. Option is given. When that option is properly utilized, when it is used for our elevation, unfoldment, parinama, then it is called yoga. Yoga is to unfold. Yoga is to raise. Yoga is to come up. Yoga is to become superhuman. We have all come here, and nature. In the nature, there are several steps. First step is inertia. The mic is inert. It is not sensitive. The stone is inert. It has no sensitivity. And this stone level is called inert matter, inertia. Even that stone, according to some people, has life, energy. In Karnataka, there was a great divine sculptor called Jakkana. He was able to find the stone to be sensitive. Some stones are willing to be carved into statues, some are unwilling. Willing and unwilling, it is the will of the stone. Some are male rocks, some are female rocks. They were able to find life, sensitivity, willingness even in the stones. But apparently for us, it is insensitive. Chaitanya Rahita. It has no sense of response. Ordinary people. In our body, we have two items. One is hair. Hair does not feel the pain. It does not express its willingness or unwillingness. Nails, just like the inert matter, since we have come from that matter, the hair is insensitive, we have it. The nails are insensitive, we have it. But is there life in the hair or not? It does have the life. It grows. It becomes white. It falls. Nails have the life. They grow. Growth is not possible if there is no life. According to mythology, Vindhya mountains, Himalayan regions were accustomed to moving. They were flying. They were free for movement. Indra was chopping off their wings. And the story says some of the mountains have run and escaped from the blows of Indra, and they stayed in the ocean. What I am trying to say here is, in nature, in prakruti, there is the part which is inert. We have that inert matter. From that level, we raise to be of instincts, impulses. From the stone kingdom, from the inert kingdom, from the crude kingdom, from the rude kingdom, from the unrefined kingdom, we come to the plant kingdom. Plants have a visible life. When you go with an axe to cut the tree weeps. It wants to run away. It cannot. There are certain leaves which shrink the moment you approach. It is a clear indication of sensitivity, chaitanya, response, fear, attempt to escape. These are all the qualities of a responding mind. In the plant kingdom, we have the responsive element in the plants, and that is called impulse. In us, we have the impulses. We are sleeping in our bedroom, about 12 o'clock in the midnight, friend comes with a pin prick, he pricks the foot, the sole of the foot, and in the hard sleep, sound sleep, we pull the leg back to be free from the prick, to avoid the prick, to save ourselves from the prick. And then next morning the friend asks, I came to you at 12 in the night. I see. I gave a prick in your soul. I see. You pulled your leg back. I see. Do we know it? It is an impulsive activity. We have come from the plant kingdom. We have come from the stone kingdom. That stone inertia we have in us, that plant's impulse we have. Then we have the animal kingdom. In the animals, the intelligence further grows. There is further development. Now, instinctively we do certain things. When I see gulab jam, when I see rasgulla, my mouth waters automatically. It's an instinctive act. When a beautiful girl is seen, automatically the head turns that side to see. A female dog is followed by a male dog instinctively. We have come from the animals. We do have the instincts. The prakriti, nature, is unfolding from inertia to impulse, from impulse to instinct, and now we are at that level. We have instincts in us, impulses in us, inertia in us. This instinct should not stop there. There is a product called intellect in every one of us. It's a God's gift. Use that intellect. What for? To overcome the impulses, to overcome the instincts, and raise to be intuitive divya drishti. The intellect says, no, don't look that side. There comes your Raja Yoga. Raja Yoga is royal, princely, kingly, commanding, controlling, mastering. It controls at every level. These samskars, step after step, crude oil becomes refined oil. raw gold becomes pure gold, rude man, rude woman becomes the refined person. It is not sufficient. Left to the nature, nature is trying to take us down. For example, yesterday I brushed my teeth. I made them white. I made my mouth fragrant. Nature brings it down. Within 24 hours, the freshness goes, the brightness goes, there comes the smell. Therefore, you have to brush again. Same is the case with yoga. Yoga is to take us to the top. Brahmananda, Akhandananda, Anantananda. We have to retain ourselves in it. Ramana Maharshi, a young boy of 16 years, Venkatraman, he was living in a house opposite to the east gate of Madhura Meenakshi temple. He had no father. He passed away. He was in the house of his elder brother. Ramana, as a boy of 16, was studying SSLC in a school, Christian school. In the month of January, he went to his elder brother, Anna, fast approaching are the final examinations. I have to pay examination fee. How much is the amount? 1 rupee. Then the elder brother said, why should I waste money on you? You got 5 marks in the half yearly examination mathematics. You got 2 marks in the quarterly examination mathematics. Any investment on you is a waste. Why don't you go and die, you useless fellow? Like any parent or a guardian, the elder brother was angry. He shouted, scolded, refused to give. And the last was, why don't you die? And in Kathopanishad, Nachiketa, the young boy, was asked, I'll give you to death. I will give you to Yama. Now Ramana received that word from his elder brother. People ask me to die, die, die. What happens if I die? What is death? There he made the inquiry, Jnana. He was curious to know what would happen if death comes. And he was of strong willpower to see the death. Willpower is strength. Curiosity is the first step for knowledge, Jnana. Both were there mixed in him, Ramana Maharshi. Same is the case with the Nachiketa of Kathopanishad. Raja Yoga is nothing but determination, nothing but willpower, nothing but your strong, sturdy determination to do things. And now this Ramana went to the top of his house. There was a single room. If I die, there will be no breath. He controlled the breath. Mind will not work. Controlled the mind. Body will not move. Stopped the movement. Stopped the mentation. Total mastery over the body, mind, intellect, equipment on account of his determination, willpower, strength of mind. Total mastery over the mind, body, intellect, equipment is Raja Yoga. And then he found there is something beyond the body. There is something beyond the mind. There is something beyond the intellect. Jyoti. Jnana Jyoti. Ananda Jyoti. Ananda. Brahmananda. A state of extraordinary happiness. Ecstatic happiness, illumining, brightening everything, effulgent, Swayam Prakasha. And then there is something before birth, during the life, after the death. What is that? What is that? What is that Jnana Jyoti? He started making the inquiry, and that is the Atman. When you have the strong determination, we evolve, we rise, we grow, we unfold from Prakriti to Samskruti. If we don't, we fall to Vikruti. If the gold is not purified, it does not become burnished gold, bright gold. Having got the state, leave the gold for some time, it will lose its brightness to some extent. It is to be brushed. If you leave the teeth as they are, they become foul smelling, and therefore you have to brush. You take the asanas for a day, you feel well. After 10 days again you stop it, again we become flabby, we become obese. Continuation. And this Sri Ramana was asked, Swami, as a boy of 16 years you came to Tiruvannamalai, what was the psychic situation then? Now what is your position? What is the development? Then Sri Ramana said, what I discovered, what I realized, what I held, I continue to hold it. If I don't hold it, it will slip. If you have some water in your palm, you must be very cautious, you must be very careful, otherwise the water will slip by. Similarly, when we reach the height, we must retain that position on the top. For that, regular exercise. Prakriti is to become Samskriti. That going upward is yoga practice. That is spirituality. We go down. Materialism, worldly habits, we get rust. And this is beautifully depicted in the geographical position of our country. At the southernmost tip of this country, you have Kanyakumari Prakriti. On the northernmost top of this country, you have Shiva, pure consciousness. Prakriti evolving, Prakriti rising, Prakriti going to that stop. This Prakriti fell in love with pure consciousness. It is natural to rise high. Mythologically, Parvata Kumari, Parvati, Prakriti looked at Shiva, fell in love with Shiva, wanted to wed Shiva, and Manmatha accompanied, Vasanta accompanied. Parvati went to the presence of Lord Shiva. He opened the third eye. What is this stumbling block for the merging of the Prakriti with Paramatma? Kama. That was reduced to ashes by Lord Shiva. Manmatha was burnt, Vasanta was burnt, and Prakriti thought, Parvati thought, this is not the way to wed Lord Shiva. She came down to the southernmost tip. On that single rock, she stood on single foot. Aparna, she was taking leaves. She did penances. She did tapasya. She observed austerities. And now Paramatma himself came down. Parameshwara himself came down. Lord Shiva himself came down. When you observe the austerities, when you follow the process, when you begin to unfold yourself, inertia will go by, impulses will fall by, instincts also will disappear, and there is that intuition, Divya Drishti, Daiva Drishti, trance state, ecstatic Brahmananda, that is Parameshwara coming and wedding. Parvati. Having come to Prashanti, let us try to know from where we have come. Step by step, let us observe the samskars to purify ourselves, to elevate ourselves, to unfold ourselves, to make ourselves divine, sublime, and then stay there in that ecstatic state, Brahmananda. And that requires determination. Whether it is Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa or Ramana Maharshi, whether it is any other great saint of this country, the requirement is determination. I must go to the top and stay on the top. I must become a yogi and continue to stay as a yogi. Raja Yoga is that strong willpower, strong determination, excellent strength, mastery over the body, mastery over the mind, mastery over the intellect. When everything is mastered, you are the master of the entire universe. We are established in that Brahmananda. Having come to Prashanti, let us use that willpower, strength, determination to become yogis. Sri Krishna is that great Yogishwara. Let's meditate on him.
Asato ma sadyamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityor ma mrutangamaya om shanti shanti shantihi sarve bhavantu sukhinah sarve santu niramaya sarve bhadrani pasyantu ma kasche dukkhabhag bhavet om shanti shanti shanti.